as beautiful and as lazy as this creature is, this dinosaur has many features that make it a deadly addition to our docuseries. Join us in discovering the Triceratops. After having taken their drink from the pond, the adolescent grabs a bite to eat, and then they make their journey to their nesting grounds. Every year, the Triceratops will migrate, like a bird, to the nesting grounds. Normally they move in a herd for protection, but these pudgy, lazy bastards slept through their alarms, and their parents just gave up on them. They aren't too concerned, as the horns on their head and the shield protecting their neck make them a rival for the Tyrannosaurus, which means they have the confidence to travel at night, even as youngins. However, they still need their rest, and they decide to collect it at dawn. When they are ready, the males go get breakfast while the female just sits there, lazy fuck, or tired. We don't really know. Finally, when the female is hurting enough, she finally gets up to get some food and water. Good thing too, or this episode will be over quickly. She rejoins the males, who are sunbathing, in just enough time for them to continue their journey, to find more food so they can move on to the next synchros, which their timing turns out to be impeccable. All right, facts about the Triceratops. They actually gave me a book this time. But I'm not gonna fucking use it. I'm a nerd, so yeah, here we go. The Triceratops was the largest horned herbivore to walk the face of the earth, which actually Triceratops translates to three-horned lizard. Due to the three large horns on its head, the two above its eyes, the one above its nose, and the shield over its neck. Which Triceratops, the shield over its neck, was one very big solid shield, unlike the holed shield like the Torosaurus. This dinosaur, for one of odd reason, was the number one prey to the Tyrannosaurus, and it was also the rival, given the horns of the main weapon of defense. The three Triceratops head downriver to what they feel is their new nesting grounds. But only time and we will tell what lie beyond. They run further into the jungle, following the water, crossing over a small waterfall, and coming up on a lake with some islands. This is where they decide to break off from the water and gain some high ground. Which was smart because their herd did not do that and they all perished. Just a day earlier, the area flooded with half the herd drowned and the other half was lunch. The younger male goes swimming in the lake, not realizing that the lake is flooded, and he is swimming over the dead bodies of his parents. Once they find a decent high ground, they play for a few moments to waste energy, and then resort to sunbathing when all of their energy is spent. The two males reach adulthood just as it starts raining, which is ironic. And the female watches with mating anticipation. Meanwhile, off in the distance, the last member of the herd that followed theirs, the Edmontosaurus, approaches. Being another herbivore, there is no hostility between the two species, and it looks like the Edmontosaurus is just wandering around to observe the three now adults as the female makes her nest. It looks like our three Triceratops will make it to repopulate the species. The Tyrannosaurus won't know what hit them. So join us next time as we go back further in time to evaluate, in a shorter episode, the Carnotaurus.